everybody wants to, like, have a say, or, you know, they're keyboard warriors, or, like, people just like to talk, you know?
Well, you know what? Those are the people that you know where they're coming from.
They want something to complain about. If you don't like it, don't watch it.
Simple rule, right? You figure if you don't like it, if you don't like the way it tastes, you don't eat it. You don't like if you don't right. like the way your car drives, don't drive it. So, yeah, no.
Listen, I don't like football. I've been following wrestling my whole life. That's the only sport I watch. I don't watch any other sport. I could care less about football. I never watched a game in my entire life. So I'm not going to watch it just because, like, when the Super Bowl comes on, everybody, oh, you going to the game? No, I don't even know who's in it. I could care less because I don't like it. I'm not going to watch it.
Right.
And I never like the home team. You know why? Because everybody else does. I like to be the exact opposite.
Yeah.
I will never cheer for the Phillies or the Eagles. I hate Philadelphia teams.
Well, people in Philly don't give you exactly good reasons to like anything out of Philly.
Philly fans are the worst fans. When their team is losing, they'll say they suck. You know what I mean? But if they're winning, they're the best. As soon as they lose. When I did follow baseball, I liked the New York Yankees. And you know what? I liked them even if they lost. I didn't badmouth them. I tuned in the next time. You know? Yeah. But I got out of baseball and just concentrated on wrestling. And that's the only sport I've watched.
Well, I mean, yeah, I'm kind of the same way. I mean, I like the Mets locally. Other than that, the other sports, I don't like anybody anymore. So, but Mike, I do appreciate you giving us a call. I told you this would be painless. Wasn't a painful conversation, correct?
Yeah, I wasn't scared.
Well, because a lot of people like to talk, and a lot of people like to say, oh, you know, he's going to get this one, he's going to get that one, this one's calling in.
Yeah,
and I never said that. I never said I was having people call in, and I said I was just going to ask questions.
I've had people badmouth me, like, on the internet and all, and I see them in person, and they don't say peace. You know what I mean? It's like, well, what happened? You know, there's that other guy. I don't know if you heard of him, Keith Zimmer. Do you know who he is?
Was it Keith? Who?
Keith Zimmer. He used to travel with Sean Carr, you know, when we were using Sean. We actually put him and his buddy in an angle and stuff, and then we stopped using him. I mean, they weren't wrestlers. Now he thinks he's a promoter. He actually posted today. I mean, I have him blocked, so I don't, but people screenshot it. And he's actually talking about how he's going to be helping Impact Wrestling and stuff. Like, why would they be using this guy? You know what I mean? He's just talking out his ass.
Yeah, I just pulled him up on Facebook. No, I'm not friends with him. I don't think I've met him.
He badmouthed me and everything, but when I seen him at the convention, he just walked by and didn't say peep, and he actually took a flyer for the show. But he didn't say anything, but then he'll go badmouth me. Right. But when I see him in person, not a word.
Well, to be honest with you, if we've met, I don't even remember, to be honest with you, because I know that the 3 years on the show said you guys all met me before, and I don't... actually, Joe, I do remember meeting Joe, but I don't remember meeting Marcus or yourself.
Oh, you met Joe before?
I think I met Joe at a show, either at a show or one of those conventions.
Well, I'm saying I had to be ECWA, so because he don't really go to shows either.
Yeah. Because, you know, everybody said that they know me and blah, 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 blah. And, you know, and then the guy who called up on your show, he's pretty funny that he wanted to take personal pot shots at me for whatever reason. I have no idea who he is. I can care less.
Well, you know, like, when people like each other, like you like Chad, you're going to stick up for Chad. People like me, they're going to stick up for me. That's just the way it is. You know?
I agree, but when I did stick up for Chad, it was calling you out on whatever that had to do with you and your company. It was never, oh, Mike's fat, Mike's ugly, Mike's an asshole. You know, it was none of that crap. There's no reason for that.
The only thing that you said true is I'm an asshole. I'm not fat. I'm a great fucking guy. That's what the girl tells me.
But apparently, your guy doesn't know, hasn't met me in a while because In the last 15 months, I've lost almost 170 pounds. So I don't know.
I don't know
what he's basing his information on.
No, I don't know either. So. But, like, listen, Joe's always been doing wrestling with me for a long time.
Right.
And he knows I'm an asshole. And he'll tell you, he says he went to print out a list of my enemies, and he ran out of paper. the thing is, listen, I've talked shit on DJ Hyde. I put DJ Hyde in the ECWA Hall of Fame. You know what I mean? Like, he called me not too long ago about doing something. No matter what you say about people in wrestling, like I said, if there's the chance for them to work, they're going to do it. It doesn't matter whether you hate each other. I know people that hate each other when they see each other. They're like, hey, and they're hugging each other and taking selfies with each other,
Right. No, I understand. Like I said, I appreciate you giving us a call, and hopefully this is all done and over with in the past. Everybody can move on and do their own thing, and hopefully, in a perfect world, everybody is, and their bottom line is always going to be good.
Well, thanks a lot for having me on the show, and hope we cleared some issues up, and we're going to be concentrating on ECWA, and you're welcome to come out October 13th if you don't have another show, but I think that is a Legends of the Ring convention.
Yeah, it's a Warriors of Wrestling weekend, too, that night.
Right, so...
But I appreciate it.
Well, I'll see you sometime in the future.
All right, Mike, you got it.
All right, thank you.
Take care.
Have a good night.
That was Mike Tartaglia of ECWA, and I'm hope that all said and done, this is over and done with. Let's take our last commercial break and wrap up the show, because we did not get to play these commercials, and I don't want my sponsors yelling at me.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
Sky Wrestling Superstore in the world-famous Englishtown Flea Market. Blue Building, booths 46 through 48. Check them out for all your wrestling memorabilia needs. They have figures, lucha masks, t-shirts, retro collectibles, DVDs, cards, and so much more. You can also pick up tickets to local indie wrestling promotions. That's right, you heard it here on the Damage 365 Radio Network, the Funkenstein Wrestling Superstore in the world-famous Englishtown Flea Market, Blue Building, booths 46, 47, and 48. Check them out on Facebook at facebook.com/Funkenstein Inc. for more information.
This is Eddie Edwards, one half of the Wolves, and you are listening to Damage 365 Radio, where the hunt is on.
Do you laugh so hard to other podcasts, you're a danger on the road?
Granny shifting, not double clutching like you should.
Do you drive your friends crazy going on and on about said podcasts?
You're an idiot.
Do you have trouble falling asleep at night?
For 6 months... I couldn't sleep.
If you've answered yes to one or all three of these questions, have no fear.
Here at After the Credits, we have patented a formula of quasi-cogent opinion seasoned with shameless in-bickering to provide you with an experience that is both AAA safe and moderately amusing.
So join the dueling duo of Robert Kajowski and Norton every week for the latest in trailer and movie reviews, as well as the occasional TV talk. Because at After the Credits on Damage 365 Radio, we believe in four things.
Water's wet, the sky's blue, women have secrets.
And that listening to our show will guarantee that your insurance premiums will plummet.
Neither Robert nor Norton can legally ensure a smooth experience on the road. Some drivers are chess monsters. Additionally, neither After the Credits nor Damage 365 Radio can legally guarantee any insurance premiums will go down. After the Credits, however, can be heard on the iHeartRadio app available through Google Play and iTunes.
This is Lanny Poffo, formerly the genius full of glory and renown. You are listening to Damage 365 Radio.
Esposito's Pizza and Pasta. Check us out on one of our fine locations, 930 Route 34 in Mattawan, New Jersey, or 233 East Main Street in Manasquan, New Jersey. From pizza and salads to pasta and buffalo wings, we have something to suit every member of your family. Whether you're seeking to take out, delivery, or just want to dine in, let us do the dishes. We would be more than happy to take care of your next meal. Our courteous and friendly restaurant staff is here to meet and exceed all your expectations. We promise an enjoyable experience each and every time we serve you. Try our award-winning Sesame Seed Crust Pizza, the recent winner of first place in the Las Vegas Pizza Open in the Artisans Division. Visit us online at sesameseedpizza.com for store hours, menus, and phone numbers, or just stop by one of our two great locations. You'll be glad you did. Esposito's Pizza and Pasta, so close to eating at Mom's, but without all the yelling.
This is former WWE superstar Damian Sandow, now known as Aaron Stevens, and you're listening to Damage 365 Radio. Keep it tuned. You're welcome.
The following announcement has been paid for by the New World Order.
WarriorsOfWrestling.com. See roster profiles of past and present Warriors of Wrestling stars. Over 50 highlight videos of Warriors of Wrestling events, full-length matches, order tickets to future Warriors of Wrestling events, an extensive DVD collection featuring past events, compilations, documentaries, and much, much more, only at WarriorsOfWrestling.com.
This is Jim the Anvil Neidhart, and you're listening to Damaged Radio 365. Yeah, baby!
And welcome back, and I'd like to thank all our sponsors, and again, I'd like to thank ECWA's Mike Tartaglia for coming on, and all the contributions that other people made, whether you were a fan, a worker, or whatnot, whatever, for sending us some of the questions that you wanted answered. I hope we covered everything. That's really it. So I appreciate everybody coming on. I appreciate everybody listening and tuning in. We're going to be back, of course, next week with another episode of the Indy Super Show. And, hopefully we have a nice guest lined up, or we'll just wait to see, who does something stupid in the world of wrestling, and then we can talk about it. So that's about it. So as always, we ask that you help control the nitwit population and have your friends spayed or neutered. On behalf of my entire staff and all my sponsors, I bid you a farewell.
To see by my eyes and all I was told.